Was there ever a time where you were hesitant on getting the COVID-19 vaccine? Was there ever a time when you let the news and gossip get to you about the COVID-19 vaccine? This, in other words, is called vaccine hesitancy. This will be the topic of today's video. In this video, we will be talking about science mistrust or hesitancy, particularly regarding the COVID-19 vaccine. We will discuss vaccine hesitancy and where it stems from. We will introduce a study that displays science mistrust. We will explain the flaws of this study and then end with a conclusion. The contents of this video are in no way persuading or abstaining individuals from obtaining the COVID-19 vaccine. Please seek the advice of a medical professional if assistance is required for decision-making regarding the COVID-19 vaccine. Now, let's get back into it. Vaccine hesitancy is the process of delaying or refusing vaccine administration although the vaccine is available. Vaccine hesitancy may arise due to numerous factors such as a lack of trust in the government and pharmaceutical companies, underestimating the severity of the disease, a fear of needles, a lack of time, or misinformation due to the media, which will be the topic of today's video. A main fear comes from what might happen to the body if the vaccine is administered. Many individuals become misinformed about vaccines due to the spreading of false scientific information. Social media has allowed for the rapid spread of misinformation, particularly when individuals forward messages they see on social media, spread assumptions by word of mouth, or misinterpret scientific information. Essentially, there's a game of broken telephone where medical misinformation is spread from one person to the next. Speaking of medical misinformation, have you heard of the claim that vaccines are being administered incorrectly, and that as a result, there's a risk of acute myopericarditis? A study that fueled this claim was published in August 2021 and is called Intravenous Injection of COVID-19 mRNA Vaccine Can Induce Acute Myopericarditis in Mouse Model. For context, myopericarditis is the inflammation of the pericardium, which is a two-layered sac that covers the outside of the heart. The study's main purpose was to investigate whether accidental intravenous injection of the COVID-19 mRNA vaccine can induce acute myopericarditis. In the methods of this study, there is a control group and two experimental groups. The control group consisted of mice that received a saline injection, which created no effect. The two experimental groups consisted of mice that received one of two routes of administration, either an intravenous injection or the intramuscular injection. In simpler terms, this means that the injection was either administered within a vein or deep into the muscle. The researchers measured signs of myopericarditis in each group to see if there is an effect due to intravenous injection. The results of this study showed that rats who were injected intravenously showed more signs of myopericarditis. The study concludes that myopericarditis following mRNA injection could be due to the incorrect administration of the vaccine, particularly the intravenous route. This study fueled a great deal of vaccine hesitancy among lay people. However, we cannot make broad claims about what should be done based on one study alone. As we will see, experts had many concerns about the study. One major concern was outlined by Elizabeth Bick, who is a science integrity expert known for identifying photomanipulation. According to Bick, there were unexpected similarities between the photos for different treatment groups. Remember that the study involved three different experimental groups: a control group, an intravenous group, and an intramuscular group. In the figures posted by the researchers, these two images presented are shown to represent different groups. This image represents the intravenous group, and this image represents the intramuscular group. However, if you take a closer look, these images appear to be from the same mouse. If you rotate the image from the intramuscular group is the same as the one used for the intravenous group, although they are supposed to be from two different mice. Because of this, there are concerns on whether the samples have been switched, which raises concerns about whether there were errors in other samples as well. Another concern raised by Bick and others included the usage of bulb CJ mice in the study. The study demonstrated that some of their mice had pericardial fibrosis as quickly as 1 or 2 days after being given the vaccination, which seems incredibly fast. Usually, it takes around 5 days to see this extent of fibrosis. It is common to find pericardial fibrosis in bulb CJ mice, which could mean that the pericardial fibrosis that the researchers found could be a background finding. This means that the mice may have already had pericarditis before being administered the vaccination. What this means is that the experiment needs to be conducted again on a different strain of mice to show that the pericardial fibrosis found by the researchers is not just a background finding. There was also a concern about the doses of the vaccine that the mice received, where Bick argued that the rats received a vaccination dose from 50 to 500 times the dose that a normal human would receive. Too much of anything can lead to harmful effect. For example, water is healthy in moderation, but if you drink 50 to 500 times more, it could even kill you. Overall, there were many concerns presented by fellow experts that would need to be addressed before we can view the results of this one study as accurate. Outside of the flaws that may be present in a study, there are also issues with generalizing the results of a study. Many experimental observations are very specific to what they are investigating, so it may be difficult to generalize the results from this study to humans. Let's explore the issues we can face when generalizing this study to humans. One issue around the generalization of the study to humans is that in humans, intravenous injections are incredibly rare. One advantage to the site of administration in humans, the deltoid, is that the deltoid has very few veins where accidental injections could occur, making them very rare. Furthermore, the onset of pericarditis in humans has been found after 2 doses of the mRNA vaccine. The study examines the administration of 2 consecutive intravenous doses, which means that if accidental administration was the cause of myopericarditis in humans, it would have to occur after 2 consecutive incorrectly administered vaccines, of which the chances are very small. In contrast to the study presented in this video, a research study was done in Israel where researchers observed the effects of the Pfizer mRNA vaccine in patients 42 days after the second dose. In doing so, they realized that the onset of myopericarditis depends on various factors, such as age, demographics, and differs in severity. In addition, these researchers found that the majority of myopericarditis cases were in individuals with pre-existing heart problems, therefore causing researchers to conclude that COVID-19 is more likely to cause myopericarditis on its own than the vaccine itself. Overall, it is important to note that we should not jump to conclusions based on one study. This is because there can be many flaws within that one study, it is difficult to generalize the results of one study to a greater population, and there's often miscommunication about science, which is like a game of broken telephone where information gets transferred from one person to another very quickly and gets distorted along the way. It is very important for us, as the public, to understand how we obtain scientific information that is accurate. For example, we should consult reputable journal articles with many peer reviews, as that indicates that the study has been validated and accepted by experts in the field. In addition, we should ask experts such as our doctors, nurses, and scientists before making any decision about our health.